Technology has obviously changed the way we work over the last few decades, but despite the rise of computers and smartphones, we're working harder and longer than ever.
Based on current trends, almost half of Year 12 students who've just completed their exams will end up with a university degree, which is great news. So, what are the new careers just around the corner?
For more on this, we are joined by social analyst and demographer Mark McCrindle. Mark, welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
Now, firstly, how important will education be in securing, you know, jobs of the future?
Increasingly important, because it's globally competitive times now for these jobs. And of course, this generation will live longer, they'll work later, they'll have more jobs. So this foundational education matters more. That's why the tertiary studies are increasing. And also they'll have to keep plugged into education because they're going to change more careers. So they'll upskill, they'll retrain more than we've ever seen in the past.
Right.
Give us an idea of how the workforce will evolve as a result of technology.
Well, firstly, we're seeing a lot of new jobs come around because of technology, and a lot of old jobs disappear. You know, we're not seeing as many shop assistants now. We're checking our own groceries out. People are using online to buy a lot of services. No office has a typing pool anymore because everyone's doing their own, you know, technology and admin and the like. So jobs are disappearing, but I think how we work will continue to change. People will have to be more adaptive. We're going to see jobs come to an end more quickly. We're going to see whole new sectors emerge. So to remain future-proof, we'll really have to respond to these ever-changing times.
Be very flexible, willing to retrain.
Exactly.
Okay, so what are some of the jobs we're expected to see in the future then, the new jobs that we don't have now?
Well, just in the last few years, we've seen these virtual reality headsets emerge for entertainment, but now you've got real estate agents, you know, selling properties, so you don't have to view it, you can, you know, see it through the headset, travel agents using them. So a virtual reality engineer, obviously we've seen app developers and cybersecurity emerge as a whole new role. User experience managers that can design websites and technology to interface with people. Nanotechnology in a medical space, in a computing space. A lot of new sectors have emerged just in the last couple of years.
Mm. So one of the things we just had up on the screen, a blockchain engineer. What is that?
We're seeing changes. You've heard of Bitcoin. Now people are doing financial transactions, not through banks. And so it's a software system, essentially. It's like social media, but for banking. So it's opening up new payment forms, new ways of interacting and shopping. So that's we've only heard of in the last couple of years, and now it's a whole era, and we're going to see more of that emerge in the future.
And Mark, we mentioned the school students who are going to attend the universities. So the universities falling in line with making sure that these faculties, engineering, science faculties, are gearing their students towards these courses, careers?
Yeah, we're starting to see some change there, and even schools getting more innovative in what they're teaching and how they're teaching, but everything is still taught for the test. It's all about those exams. It's all about getting the results. So that's a little bit traditional. We are going to need to give people the people skills, the life skills, the social skills, the technology skills, which is often beyond just the curriculums we're equipping them with. So I think there's more change needed.
You can only imagine some of the new kids attending university and their lecturer is probably about 23 or 24, you know. These careers, these jobs that they're going to be going into are very new. They're very young.
Exactly. And, you know, you start a degree, you do a four-year degree, there's whole new careers that have emerged since you began uni, you know. Yeah. It's a fast-moving world.
And you mentioned, you know, that shop assistants and things like that, you know, we check out our own groceries. What are some of the other jobs that you think are on the way out?
We've seen over the last couple of years manufacturing really get hammered by the change in technology. Toll collectors have disappeared some years. It will be automated. Anything that can be offshored to cheaper labour bases will be. So it's about high tech, it's about innovation, it's about adaption. That's what's required. Otherwise, we're going to find ourselves in a career that's sort of headed to a dead end.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what should everybody be doing to future-proof their careers down the track?
What's key is to have people skills, because computers aren't good at dealing with people. We don't want to deal with technology, we want to deal with people. So if we've got good people skills, if we can innovate, if we can be creative, that again is something that computers won't replace. They're not designed to be creative, they're designed to do replicatable tasks. And also it's about future-proofing. It's about seeing a career that's, if it's waning, upskilling to this area, keeping your eyes on the trends, on the horizons, to remain ever relevant, to adapt, to thrive.
The future looks bright though, doesn't it? You could be this person who does so many different things throughout their career, not just one sole job.
Mm. Yeah.
And that would be very exciting, I would imagine.
Exactly, a lot more innovation. The gig economy, you do this for a while, you do that, you drive Uber cars, you do a bit of Airbnb, you know, that didn't exist a few years ago, so a lot has changed.
Great life experiences. Thanks, Mark.
Thank you so much.